Ang pinag-uusapan po natin dito ay 18 billion pesos na binili natin po yung system from Meru, from South Korea. I'd like to believe that this is a very important matter to discuss with you, considering that for quite some time this representation has been waiting for some concrete answers from the COMELEC. I must inform you that I tried to ask several questions surrounding the procurement of the Meru technology from South Korea, but until the last meeting of the Committee on Suffrage and Electoral Reforms, which was attended by COMELEC officials and representatives, I also inquired about the Meru system because of some intriguing reports that the technology as well as the machines procured by the COMELEC are not within the specifications as enunciated by our automated election law. Ang automated election law po natin, very explicit po yung sinasabi niya ron eh. The technology that must be procured, the system that must be procured, must have demonstrated capability and must have been tried successfully in prior electoral exercises here or abroad. Ang nangyari po, based on some reports, halimbawa po yung kanilang pagkakagamit ng Meru system and technology in the Democratic Republic of Congo, ang ginamit po nilang application doon ay yung tinatawag na DRE or Direct Recording Electronic Technology. At mula po sa mga reports ay sinasabi about 45% of the voting stations encountered difficulties with this Meru machines. Ganun din po sa Iraq na sinasabi nila na ang ginamit na technology ay tinatawag na OMR. Ito yung Optical Mark Recognition or Optical Mark Reader technology. Nagkaroon din po ng glitch. The report says that about 70% of the voting stations also resulted in confusion and difficulties that ended up in manual elections. Ito po yung kinatatakot natin. Ako po bilang isa ay nagpahayag din. Kagaya ng sinasabi ko doon sa huling meeting ng Committee on Electoral on Suffrage and Electoral Reforms, nagtanong po ako tungkol dito, waiting that the COMELEC should come up with some answers to allay the fears of people like us. Ang pinag-uusapan po natin dito ay 18 billion pesos na binili natin po yung system from Meru, from South Korea. Yung terms of reference po ng COMELEC, so yung TOR, ang minimum requirement po doon, sinasabi niya, that the ACM that will be procured shall be using a combination of the DRE at saka po yung OMR. Meaning to say, the machines that will be procured are hybrid machines, capable of using a combination of two applications, meaning OMR and DRE. Ang tinatanong ko po ay, meron na po bang napatunayan na ang Meru ay nakagamit po ng isang hybrid machine in any jurisdiction, either here or abroad, where the combination of these applications have been used? Wala pa po eh. Now, on a separate matter, nga po, sa Congo, DRE ang ginamit, merong sablay. Ginamit ang OMR in Iran, sablay din. Paano kaya kung ito'y gagamitin in combination with one another? Wala pang nangyaring ganito. So, if there is no proof that the technology coming from Meru and as well as the machines accompanying this, ay wala silang may papakita na katibayan na itong hybrid machine na ito will function in accordance with the terms of reference, then the COMELEC will be openly violating Republic Act 9369. O ito yung automated election law. Ito po yung problema. 18 billion pesos ang cost po nito. At kung wala pong matibay na katibayan, ito'y magagamit natin and we might end also in a manual election. More than the figures and behind the huge figures, huwag na po sigurong pag-usapan kung 18 billion. But I think the more important factor here is the credibility and integrity of our elections. Hindi lang naman po ako ang interesado na kailangan ma-assure natin yung integrity ng ating electoral process. Kayo po na pinatawag namin ngayon, lahat po tayo interesado to maintain clean, honest, orderly elections. Yung credibility and integrity of the elections, yun po is the primordial concern of all Filipinos like you. Eh bakit po nagkaroon po ng ganitong pag-uusap? First of all, I'd like to inform you that alam namin nyo siguro itong mga bagay nito sapagkat bukod sa akin, I think even before I started this crusade of asking the viability of the Meru system, si Mr. Alex Magno, kilala nyo siya, is a noted columnist in the Philippine Star. Basahin po ninyo yung kanyang mga articles. I believe he started in November 2023 and until May of this year, he wrote at least 8 articles sounding the alarm bells on Meru system. Pwede nga natin sabihin na si Alex Magno is the modern day John the Baptist. The only voice crying in the wilderness. Pero kagaya ko din, hindi siya nakakuha ng sagot. The Comelec preferred to be silent, as silent as the monument, for reasons only known to them. Ito po yung gusto nating sabihin. Ang Supreme Court po sa kanyang recent ruling, it ruled that the Comelec committed grave abuse of discretion in disqualifying Smartmatic from the bidding process. Alam po ninyo ang nangyari. Even before the bidding took place, Comelec disqualified Smartmatic on the mere information supplied by the Justice Department of the United States relating to a criminal investigation about the alleged irregularity in the procurement of AES at the time of 2016 election during the term of then Chairman Andres Bautista. So without hearing the side of Smartmatic, dinisqualify sila, depriving it of its right of due process. Tama po ba yun? So isa na lang po yung bidder. And therefore, there was no competitive bidding. Ano po ang nangyari ron? If there is no competitive bidding, then Comelec violated Republic Act 9184. Bukod doon, Comelec violated their own internal rules and regulation, which describes in detail the bidding process. Then walang bidding na po eh. So ano po ngayon ang delikado? How can we assure the integrity of our election system? How can we assure the outcome of the 2025 elections? Ano po ba yung epekto ng desisyon ng Korte Suprema? When the Supreme Court ruled that Comelec committed grave abuse of discretion, ano po yung significance nun? Legally speaking, an act committed with grave abuse of discretion is void. It is non-existent. So the question is, why did not the Comelec rule that the bidding is void? Ganito po ang nangyari. The Supreme Court chose to apply what we call the operative fact doctrine. Yung operative fact doctrine applies where the acts committed before the determination of their constitutionality produce consequences that cannot always be disregarded. Meaning to say, if they can set aside the action, but the effects remain.